Hello, everyone. Welcome to VOD of Consciousness with Santier. I'm Santier, and I'm totally stealing Jazza of Draw with Jazza's introduction style, arrangement, whatever. I decided, on the basis of things that I'm wanting to do, that I would not talk to this person, because that is not the person I need to talk to. I wanted to talk to the Kurzic bureaucrat. So there's a bunch of skills of each thing. And I think that I want to go ahead and grab a bunch of the Kurzic skills for... let's see. Each photo suffering condition hex you can do energy. Or whatever. I'm going to go ahead and grab some of these skills that would be useful to me. This one, for example, is not. Triple shot seems like it could be good. Let's see. Selfless spirit. What is this? Aura of Holy Might. Yeah, that's pretty good, but not what I'm trying to do. All spirits you control, show step to your location, and gain health. Well, I'm not trying to do that either. An Elemental Lord is not any good for not elementalists. I'll grab Summon Spirits as well. Why not? So now my Kurzic faction has dropped tremendously. You'll also notice it wipes out your Luxon faction when you do that, which is fine. I did not need it. My Sentinel of the Kurzic's title track will have advanced, I believe. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe you have to... raise faction reputation. Raise alliance reputation. That one. Each time you redeem faction points for a reward, you'll make progress. Yeah, okay. Anyway, I'm not worried about the other stuff there. I just thought I'd go ahead and do that in case there was something interesting. So I was going to do that, and then I'm going to go ahead and go to St. Andragus Shrine. And continue on with the things that I was trying to do, which require me to go this way. I should clean out my inventory. I'm sorry, I did not think to do this before this exact moment in time, or I would have. Okay, that's some cloth, and ID this, ID that. IDing even white items generally increases the gold yield you get from selling them. Not worth it if they're low level, but when they're high level like this, it's definitely worth doing. Let's see. Smiting rod. Okay, all that stuff can go away. I forget if this game implemented die previewing. I should double check that before I wonder about that too much. But yeah, I don't remember what different Paragon armors look like anyway. I was thinking about changing up my build a little bit, but I don't have a legitimate reason to do so right now. I'd have, like, no ranger skills as it is, so... Yes, this is the direction I need to go. So I'm not going to. That's just, you know, how it works. If I had 100 gold on me, I could spend it at the priest to get a blessing that gives me some health regen, I think, and gives me faction points when I kill enemies. But I'm not dealing with that. Okay, good. I'm still a ranger. That's the important part right there. Chicker Thousandtail is the boss that I want to kill for his precious, precious barrage. I will promptly not make use of because I don't have a bow on this character. I can't. It's a bow attack. What do you want from me? Hey, fur. It's a rare crafting material. There we go. Table that guy. Oh, there's something that I was looking at that I was like, oh yeah, that would be a great thing to talk about. Now I've forgotten what it was, so I'm going to have to look at my topic list, which interferes with my active playing of the game. Oh yeah. I wanted to take a moment. This is probably not going to take very long, but to rant a little bit about stuff that's treated as like security information that's really not secure. This is going to be things like birth date. Why is birth date, like knowing my birth date, some sign of identifying, like, that I'm me. It's super easy to find people's birth dates. Like, that should not be considered private information. In that identifying sort of sense. There's Chicker. And social security numbers in the United States of America are really, 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 like, they were not made to be an identifier. And everybody just started using them like one. They used to say that they weren't supposed to be an identifier. Something I think happened to the United States of America that was real bad for it was the Cold War has made certain ideas very negatively viewed in the United States. So basically anything that sounds like it could be communism or socialism are treated as anti-American. We should have proper national identification numbers and all of that jazz, but we don't. And that's unfortunate because I think it could be done in a way that's a lot more secure and doesn't lead to identity theft the way social security numbers easily do. But it's one of those things where you'd have to fundamentally change a lot of stuff about how Americans do things, and that's not easy. But it really should be done for something more secure. I thought I saw some other... maybe not. Just the NPC I need to go talk to. But anyway, the big problem that I have with social security numbers is that they're kind of simultaneously a username and a password. Like, you don't make your username and your password the same thing. Because that's just, like... You would not do that. Like, if you're signing up for a website, please don't do that. That is like, bad security 101 of things to not do because it is bad security. Is making your username and password the same thing. Like, that's worse than making your password 123456 and your username ABCDEFG or something. Like, it's worse than that. This guy joins us. He's going to become an eternal thingy. He's going to become a tree person. Juggernaut. That's what they are. They're really cool looking. They remind me a lot of a Magic Card Champion of Vitukazi. I don't know. But it's this big, like, 4/7 with Vigilance and Convoke or whatever. And it looks really sweet. These guys look fairly similar stylistically. That's neither here nor there. I just think they look cool. Is Cordwallis new? I didn't even... Okay. I mean, I accept. I wasn't trying, but I accept. I accept this random gift of a quest item. See, there's actually a zone, like, right over there, but we're not going to go to it because that would cancel our quest and make us have to start over from the beginning, and that is not something we want to do. But yeah, so United States absolutely should adopt some sort of proper national identification number with proper security built into it, where knowing it doesn't, like, where it's a username and a password and you have to be, like, handing it out to everyone while at the same time that is... easily leads to identity theft. It's just the worst system. I mean, I suppose you could come up with a worse one, but please don't. Also, something that's really weird about these Kurzic areas is these absolutely enormous steps that you just kind of... They're ramps, but they're, like, scaled really, really big for no clear reason. So, you know, that's a thing. While we're by a merchant, I'm going to sell these Chris daggers. And apparently I need a new ID kit, so... You can see superior salvage kits, so 2 platinum, so you can see why I want to get them for free. Like I do. With all of my equipment requisitions and stuff. Yeah. And up here we have... And I feel like I might have talked about this at some other point in time for some reason... But we have a really awkward bit of dialogue between NPCs. Awkward, not so much from what they say, but because the timing is weird. And leads to them saying a pair of lines out of order. It's been a problem for a very long time, as long as I can remember, and it's never been fixed, and I have zero reason to believe it will be fixed. So, you know, there's that. Stone Scale Kirin need to go down. Yep, they went down. Okay, let's just talk to Libra over here. Thunders of the Forest, yeah. So, he'll talk, saying his farewell to Anya, his wife, and it's all very nice, whatever, but there's a pair of lines that they say out of order, and it is very confusing. And it took me a long time to figure out that was what was going on. I don't know why it wasn't ever caught and fixed, but there it is. Let's see. Yeah, right here, I think it is. Sacrifice that you have made. I think right here, he's supposed to say, remember me, but don't mourn for me, Anya. I want you to find happiness again. And she says, don't say that, Libra. You will always be my husband. And then he's supposed to respond, I need to know that you'll move on, Anya. I can't do this if I know you'll be mourning me forever. Please promise me you won't do that. I promise, Libra, but know that I will always remember you. I love you. I love you too, Anya. Farewell. Well, I suppose this is it, then. Let's go. Right. So we need to go over this way. So there's the last person's over there, which is fairly close to where this particular quest terminates. It takes a little while to get through all this area, but it won't be too terribly bad, I don't think. We're almost through. I think there's a crippling anguish mesmer boss that'll be coming up, though, so that's a thing. Hey, if we can skip fighting those mantis, all the better. It speeds things up. What's the best way to get across? I need to cross the river, and I don't remember the exact... Let's not fight those two ritualist bosses. That sounds good to me. Oh, aggroed over here. Definitely want to make sure we take care of that. Got this birthday cupcake. Not sure how long this birthday celebration for the game is going on for, but whatever. We left some spirits over there, which means I am definitely taking the long way around. Well, that's my mistake, but whatever. In my defense, it's been a little while since I've done this quest. By the way, consider supporting me on Patreon at patreon.com/skintier. That's my I don't have anything to say, so I'll say this line. I definitely do appreciate the support, though, that anyone can give. There are different perks for different tiers, by the way. From really, they kind of start at $3. There's a $1 tier, which gets you access to a special patron posting for each Rambler, which, you know, is a spot where you can kind of say things for patrons only. I'd like to change that to getting stuff ahead of time, but that's not realistic right now. I'd have to build up a bit of a backlog on Ramblers, and that's not likely. Could happen someday, we'll see, but for right now, that is definitely not what that's about. But anyway, at $3, there's a bonus patron podcast. It's a different topic suggested by and voted on by patrons for what the topic's going to be. And at the next tier, the $5 tier, which is kind of where things really start ramping up, there's a daily audio log that I record. And that's recorded daily as opposed to once a week like this is. This is recorded in the week's worth of episodes for this are recorded in one long recording session. So, I recorded this, what is today? Like, May 3rd, I think? Yeah, May 3rd. Tuesday tends to be the day that I record stuff, so. It's not surprising that I recorded on it. Probably record the Rambler later today, but anyway, $5, you get those, and I do, talk about Bible Gateway's verse of the day, and talk about what's going on in my life. Sometimes they're short, sometimes they're long. But so there's that. And then there's also a $10 tier, which is exactly the same as the $5 tier. It's just a way for people to be generous if they want to. So if you want to, I think I call it like lazy generosity. The Patreon allows you to specify how much you want to donate and what tier you want for, want to be contributing to, as long as it is at least the, like, so you can, like, spend $500 on a, or pledge $500 on a Patreon and get the $1 reward if you want to. But I figured, you know, why not make it easy for people if they want to be more generous, they can do it at $10. At $13.37, which is, of course, an internet joke. Okay, so for this quest, I'm just going to interrupt myself because this is annoying. So for this quest, you have to wait for all of the NPCs to walk up here. Then you can talk to this guy. Then you can click on this. Then you can say, let's go. And then you say, I'm ready. And then he says, yes. You have to go through, like, four confirmations that you're ready to go in. It's like, they cut that down. Ooh, cutscene. This pacing is really bad.
It's been a long time since we bested Shiro.
I was thinking the same thing. I fear his return will not be long in coming.
You worry about things that will never come to pass.
Shiro is still a threat. The affliction will return.
Nonsense! Shiro is gone once again, and with him the affliction. You should know you were there.
Yes, but...
Shiro is in the past. We must be mindful of the present. The Luxans are the biggest threat to us Kurziks, and it is to them we must shift our focus.
Baron Vassburg! Baron Vassburg!
What news?
Baron, the Luxans have breached the forest. They're on the march as we speak.
To the Eternal Grove! Protect the Forever Trees! Kill the Luxan invaders!
So anyway, just to kind of conclude, the 1337 tier, the elite tier, is just for fun and has a few, let's go get our quest reward, and has, I release songs for it. I am not a musician or anything, but I have some fun, and hopefully the people at that tier have some fun too. And for example, there's some bonus stuff that I will on rare occasion release there, like I released on it for the test video for this whole setup. So anyway, until next time, everyone, take care. Bye-bye.